BMW G310 GS versus Royal Enfield Himalayan, which one's more capable? We pit two of the most affordable entry-level adventure tourers against each other spec-wise to see which one has more potential off the road. Adventure tourers are one of the motorcycles that appeal to two-wheelers enthusiasts the most because of their inherent capability to go anywhere. Moreover, motorcycling is all about freedom, and ADV bikes seem to be the right type of steed which will be your trusty companion in your two-wheeled adventures. BMW Motorrad launched its most affordable GS, the G310 GS, recently. Here's how it performs against the already exist Royal Enfield Himalayan design. One glance at the BMW G310 GS and you will immediately recognize the legendary GS genes running through the motorcycle. The front brake, muscular fuel tank, shapely seat ending with a high seat luggage rack at the rear are all reminiscent of the bigger bikes in the product family. However, the amount of plastic on the motorcycle may deter hardcore enthusiasts from getting their bikes dirty, at least in stock condition. The Royal Enfield Himalayan, on the other hand, has an extremely no-nonsense design, and the Honok at Royal Enfield have clearly given more importance to functions that form here. There are metal protector on the side of the fuel tank, which also double up as a mounting point of jerry cans. The tail rack is slightly smaller compared to the GS, but Royal Enfield offers the option of installing saddle stays for hard painters as well. This doesn't mean that all hopes are lost on the BMW. The German mark will be bring in a full range of accessories for the GS as well, which should make the bike more practical. In their international catalog, BMW is offering a 30-liter waterproof lockable hard top box, a smaller top box of 29-liter inner bag for top box, a 13 to 20-liter tank bag, 15mm lower or higher seat than the standard one, LED indicator, smartphone cradle, and a range of BMW navigation devices. Expect at least most of them to be offered for the Indian market eventually. Of course, these accessories are expected to be priced at a relatively more premium compared to the Himalayan instrumentation. The BMW G310 GS comes with a fully digital console which has dual trim meters, coolant temperature range, average and current fuel consumption, average speed date apart from the regular like speedo, taco and the likes. The Royal Enfield Himalayan, on the other hand, gets an analog digital combo cluster with a digital compass as well. The digital insert features an external in temperature readout, dual trim meters with their average speeds, maintenance indicator, clock, apart from speedo, odo, gear indicator, etc. Overall, both the motorcycles are well equipped to keep the rider informed about various parameters during the ride. Powertrain being the more expensive one, the BMW G310 GS also has the more modern 313cc single-cylinder liquid-cooled engine compared to the Himalayan's 411cc single-cylinder motor with air cooling and oil cooler. Let's get the power difference away first. 34 PS at 9500 RPM and 28 Nm at 7500 RPM with a 6-speed transmission for the GS, and 24.8 PS at 6500 RPM and 32 Nm at 4250 RPM coupled with a 5-speed gearbox. The Beamer seems to be more power based in comparison to the torque heavy Himalayan. Another distinguishing point is that the sophistication comes complication. Though the G310 GS may be powerful, there are more chances for things to go wrong when pushing the motorcycle to its limits. Notwithstanding the Himalayan's notoriety for quality, the simpler construction for its engine would make it relatively easier to repair than the GS. Moreover, you get the assurance of knowing that there are hundreds of Royal Enfield service centers located across India compared to only 7 dealerships in the entire country for the BMW. Underpinning. The Himalayan rolls on 41mm telescopic fork with 200mm travel upfront and linked monoshock with 180mm wheel travel. The baby GS features a more sophisticated 41mm inverter forks and preload adjustable monoshock at the rear, both offering 180mm travel. Going by the two bike suspension, the Himalayan seems to be the more capable one when going off-road. Moreover, the Himalayan's rudimentary telescopic fork setup can handle oil leaks much better than the GS advanced inverter forks. Though both the bikes come with dual purpose tires, Himalayan spoke wheel setup can take up shock loads much better than rigid rod-based alloy wheels of the G310 GS. However, with a 300mm front and 240mm rear disc with dual channel switchable ABS, the GS seems to be the safer bet than the Himalayan, considering the latter comes with the same disc size but without ABS. The GS also features radial caliper as opposed to the Himalayan's traditional unit. Verdict. Coming to the price, the BMW G310 GS cost a whopping Rs 3.49 lakh, where the Himalayan will set you back Rs 1.68 lakh, both ex-showroom Delhi. The amount of features the GS offer doesn't exactly justify the fact that it costs more than twice the price of the Himalayan. Sure, it's about snob value. But for the hardcore adventure enthusiasts, that's not exactly a priority. The Himalayan, on the other hand, may come with its own set of niggles, but for the price, it still stands unbeatable, at least in the Indian market. The upcoming KTM 390 adventure will surely make things more interesting.